there's lots of new innovations coming through in the materials industries, whether that be buildings or clothing or textiles. The aim is to create a future where there's no waste. And I think there really is a sense of urgency to try and find sustainable methods. The input into the system would come from biological materials that are grown, materials like mycelium. It's a very compelling biomaterial. It can be produced in different ways that it can be adaptable to different applications. Mycelium really is a bit of a wonder material. My name's Jane Scott and I am a researcher in the Hub for Biotechnology in the Built Environment. Mycelium is really transforming the world of materials. Not only can we grow this material and transform it through quite simple manufacturing processes that don't require extensive heat or power or energy, but also I think thinking through that material life cycle, either a mycelium product can be biodegradable because all the components are natural. It's got great insulation properties. It's a very clean material. It's non-toxic. It's naturally fire retardant. So really all these properties together mean that it is perfect for applications in the built environment and a number of manufactured goods. Mycelium combined into composites can take the benefit of the other materials. So for example, in combination with waste cellulose material can offer a really robust alternative to using plastic for packaging, and it produces a packaging material that's biodegradable. Pure mycelium actually is a really compelling alternative to leather. It can be produced in such a lot of different ways that it can be adaptable to different applications. There's interest in actually taking mycelium beyond manufactured materials. It has an amazing ability to clean up waste environments, so even kind of chemicals or hydrocarbons from oil. So it's really a very versatile new biotechnology that's coming through. I think one of the problems with materials is that we tend to use them in a linear system. So we extract the materials, we process them, we use them, and then we dispose of them. And I think more and more we're beginning to understand that we need to work towards circular systems so we don't waste materials. We have the ability to grow the bespoke products that we need. So rather than everything being kind of a mass-produced material, the future with mycelium is to design the appropriate solutions that we would want. So it might be in a building that rather than it being kind of standardized material, we can think very closely about what this particular building needs and design a bespoke mycelium textile composite to work with that. I mean, it really excites me to think that we could move towards a future where all the components of a building could be grown. I think industries are very committed to circularity. I think materials are key to creating a circular bioeconomy because they are the constituent component of the products, buildings, the fabrics that we wear. I'm excited about the future, but it's not just about the people making the materials, it's about all of us and how we use materials. And I think actually we as consumers are now engaged and really passionate about the materials that we use in our everyday lives. I think the future for mycelium-based materials is really exciting.